Good day to you. It's Resurrection Sunday, Easter, and it is a noonday broadcast. Some of you have just finished our morning Easter broadcast, but this is noonday broadcast. And we have a special word for you from Ephesians chapter 4. Unlikely chapter for resurrection, but a very powerful theological chapter. Ephesians chapter 4, there's a church epistle. Ephesians chapter 4, verse 7, but to each one of us grace was given according to the measure of Christ's gift. Therefore it says, when he ascended on high, he led captive a host of captives, and he gave gifts to men. Quoting from Psalm 68, it also says he gave gifts to rebels. So he took captive a host of captives and he gave gifts to men. Now the expression he ascended, what does it mean except that he also had descended into the lower parts of the earth? That's what he did from Good Friday 6 p.m. to Resurrection Sunday 6 in the morning or 3 in the morning, whenever he came and rolled the rock. That's what he did. And we had a wonderful vision today, but let's read this first. What does it mean except that he has had descended into the lower parts of the earth? He who descended is himself also he who ascended far above all the heavens so that he might fill all things. How is he going to fill all things? He gave some as apostles. That's how he's going to fill. He's seated at the right hand of the Father, and he gave some apostles and some prophets. Now see, there are apostles in the church, and there are apostles who get pioneering ventures, maybe in the marketplace, in the profession, in science. They are also pioneering into areas that others have not seen. You understand? So all the 19th century pioneering scientists, they were outstanding Christians. They understood the works of God. As Francis Bacon said, you need to read the book of God's word and book of God's works, the creation there. And they were real apostles. Thank God for apostles, inside, outside. So who gave? Jesus Christ gave. So what's the mandate? What's the creation mandate? He descended and ascended with gifts, capacities, callings. This is the resurrection mandate. Callings, and he arose, he ascended. Who descended is himself also he who ascended, Ephesians 4:10, far above all the heavens so that he might fill all things. In every nation, every stratum, every space, all of creation, resources that he has given to a nation, he wants to occupy and fill in the Edenic sense of the mandate. I bless you, be fruitful, multiply, fill, steward it, and have dominion over other things. So how will he do that? For that purpose, he gave. This is the mandate. Gave some as apostles, as prophets, and some as evangelists, some as pastors and teachers. Now clearly, when it says teachers, it is obviously teachers in the church and teachers also who can teach other things in other fields. This gives us the correct interpretation, pastors in the church and shepherds outside. Yes. So each of those gifts gave officers of Christ in the church and officers of Christ to function outside the church. And for the equipping of the saints, for the work of service, to the building up of the body of Christ. So works of service out there, building of the church in here. So you build the body and go out to work. So it's reciprocal relationships. God is at it all the time. Every Christian is to do this all the time. So until we all attain to the unity of faith and so on and so forth. So this is the vision I saw. Jesus Christ began the descent. And yesterday also we took it up, how he descended through ranks of Hades, disease and all kinds of things. And he appeared at the door of Hades, and his bright shining light of his presence, of his glorious resurrected spirit, having obtained the authority and having arrested the downfall of first Adam. Now the second Adam is going in all glory, creation, all glory. He is going there and he got the keys of Hades and death into his hand, and then he went through the ranks of Hades, firing cabin after firing cabin of all kinds of indictments against the nations. It was all full in my vision. It was all full of court cases, bad things, iniquities, indictments that Satan used from nation to nation, century to century, age to age, generation to generation, family to family, throne to throne, kingdom to kingdom, and even profession to profession. The things he used to put down mankind and keep dominion and make people slaves of self, slaves of sin, slaves of selfishness, nation after nation, moving nation against nation. These were his filing cabinets, all full of court cases, indictments from the throne of iniquity. But thank be to our Lord Jesus Christ, he went with the bright shining presence, his spirit went with the gates of Hades and death, and he, in one brilliant stroke of legal luminous maneuver, he removed all those files against us. You remember the cross, Colossians 2:12 said, all those sentences that were against us, he nailed to the cross, and he actualized it when he descended and ascended, and he filled the heavenly places with appointments, assignments, inheritance that saints of every age, in every nation, family to family, what they are going to occupy when they come to Christ, what Christ has made ready for every nation's redemption, because he sprinkled blood on every nation. This is the glorious story, nation after nation. Yes, sing we the King who is coming to reign. Glory to Jesus, the Lamb that was slain. Life and salvation his empire shall bring. Praise to our King. Sing we the King who is coming to reign. Yes, that's what he's going to do in every nation. And what he gave the nations to occupy, what Christians in time, apostles, prophets, marketplace people, judges, lawyers, doctors, teachers, housewives, in every locality, in every sphere, it's all written and kept. Your poga of inheritance, it's all now filed in heavenly places. Still, Germany arises. Saints in Germany arises to take their place in their time. Corona has come and has shut down the highest noonday glory of science, highest noonday glory of medical science, highest noonday glory of political maneuvering and posturing. Corona has shut down. And now when the curtain goes up again, hopefully a sobered world, a humbled world, and Christians prepared and arising during this corona time in the upper room will take up their folder, they'll take up their portfolio. One may be a minister of finance in a nation, another one may be a governor of a province in a nation, another one may be the prime minister, and bless God for the prime minister of Australia, he takes up his portfolio, and who knows, Switzerland arising, in Italy the godly arising, the Mordecai arising to be a gatekeeper, Esther arising to take the scepter, and Nehemiah arising to be the cupbearer and builder of the wall, and reinstatement of the gates even of Jerusalem. And for Spain we speak, and for France we speak, and for UK we speak, and we speak for the great battle that is on in the United States of America, and they are all waiting for the Daniel to take up his portfolio, and Joseph to take up his portfolio. Daniel in the king's place in government, Joseph in commerce, and who knows, in different places, a portfolio awaits, and it was all made, designed, assigned, and appointed, and even a signature of Jesus Christ is on it. This is what I saw. And he went to all these places and emptied hell, emptied Hades of all its indictment folders. Unless we renege, Satan has no access to them. don't renege. Fight the good fight of faith. Lay hold of eternal life. And we are there to fulfill the mandate for our nations. Arise, Christian, arise. We have heard a melody from above. And there's a deep-seated mission in our heart. There's a mandate Christ has mandated. Yes. And no mercenary, no one can muffle this. And this is the clarion call of the time. Christians in every nation arising. Malaysia, Christians are rising to take up the portfolio of Christ. And Singapore, Christians are rising. China, oh China, the church in China arising to take up their portfolio. And bamboozling, the government will say, we can't do anything because Christians are rising. In our nation, Sri Lanka, we are trusting the Lord to bless our president, bless the decision makers. We are trusting the Lord. We are trusting the Lord for a new dawn in Sri Lanka. This is our Christian greeting on Easter morning to every person seated in places of government. Happy Easter. Happy new dawn, Sri Lanka. You will once again be the pearl of the Indian Ocean. Once again, you will be the blessed isle, Sri Lanka. You will be the blessed beauty, the Serendip to the Arabs. You will be the Ceylon to the travelers, to the Greeks, that all those ships that came, they'll come once again to Sri Lanka to take our tea, take our rubber, maybe take our coconut, and maybe take our health also, because we are overcoming the coronavirus. So these are hopes for our nation. So here is the vision in short. Christ descended to Hades. That is Ephesians chapter 4 and verse 8 says, he ascended on high after that. While ascending, he took captives into his captivity. That's much better. Into his domain, in under his reign, he has taken us. We were once rebels, and there are many rebels waiting in different nations to be taken up. Musicians, entertainers, presidents, prime ministers who don't know what to do with their nations, finance ministers, industrialists, entrepreneurs waiting in nations to be taken captive by the Lord Jesus Christ to do good to their nation. As Isaiah 3 says, they will say, we don't know what to do. We don't know what to do. Things have shut up in our nations. How to revive economies? God knows what to do. God has portfolios. Be blessed. Arise in your calling. Ephesians chapter 4 is a great mandate for us. He gave and he descended himself and then he ascended far above heavens that he might fill all things. How does he fill all things? By the offices he gave immediately. Ephesians 4 10 says he might fill all things. So how will Christ fill all things seated in heavenly places? He promotes others to sit in these heavenly places of governance, be a Melchizedek, be a royal priest, but also an ambassador of Christ, bringing shalom and peace and God's prosperity to their spheres of influence. Blessed be the name of the Lord. And thank God for this marvelous strategy he has outlined. This is how church will fill the prosperity of the nation. Church will. God bless you. We will join you a little later with a academically presented story about Good Friday and Easter Sunday, how whole creation is groaning for an answer. Everybody understands that. Whole creation is groaning for an answer. Romans 8:22 says that. They have a groaning and we have a groaning that we fit into Christ's stature. Our groaning, we'll have a morning very soon. Dawn of the morning for the Christian would be the dawn of a new day for nations. We will package it in a way. You can send that clip to your friends who do not know Christ. And the evidence for his death, evidence for his resurrection, and what does it mean to us now in our nations that Christ is risen. Christ the Lord is risen today. And Charles Wesley's glorious hymn, ha ha, hallelujah. When the watch, the stone, the seal, watch was the Roman guards and seal was the legal seal, said shut him up, and the stone, none could keep him. He is risen and he has taken up his life in us. We may be little children, and our Brookside Church is doing a prayer relay around the clock virtually. and we want you to send any clip you any a WhatsApp to our telephone number 077-49-59-214. And when you are in another country, it is +94 77 49 59 214. Then when you send it, we will send our clips free of charge. God bless you.